If I was setting up for a day's drainage on one of our residential sites, one of the first things I'd do is I'd have a look at our phase plan and our plot plan. What I'd be looking at on there is a basic takeoff list of how many bends we need, how many inspection chambers we need. And more importantly, I'd be looking at the key to find out diameter of pipe as well. What I'd do then is with my list, I would go to our lay down area and I'd load our site stack up and get it moved to that plot in order that I had all the materials that I need, so I was working productively and not running around for materials all day and having it all in one place. When I'm looking at the drawing to do the takeoff list, first of all, I am looking at the key on the right-hand side. What that will do is it will tell me about private drainage and it will tell me about the adopted stuff. For the purposes of this, we're going to talk about internal plot drainage. So that there is private foul water drainage, and that gives me the diameter of pipe, and then it gives me the gradient of pipe as well. So in modern residential sites, we have two main grades of water. You'll see on the drawing that we've got SW, the storm water. So the storm water is taking all our rainwater off of the roofs and off of our road gullies, etc. And then we've got foul water inside the plot. Now the foul water is anything from the toilet, sink, grey water, and it's important to keep that separate for, you know, recycling purposes and environmental factors. So to identify an area where we're working in, we'd go back to our site plan and we'd be basically given plot numbers as to what we're working on. We'd then go to the drawing and find the specific plot number as to where we was working, and then we'd look at the finer details inside it. These black dotted lines down here are our internal drainage. Now at the end of them run, we've got rest bends, and then we've got rocker pipes going through the actual walls there. So what we can do there is we can put a list together of how many bends we basically need for that plot. So to get measurements, internal measurements on the pipe, I'd revert to the above drawing here, which gives me locations of our rest bends. So I've got measurements coming off the inside wall, and I've got measurements coming off of the bottom side flank of the wall there as well. They're quite clear on there. For an example, this one says 1 meter 735 mil in, and then it comes 495 mil off. So we've already got the foundation in and we've got the sub pot working, so it's quite simple now to measure back from the brickwork to where your rest bend is, and then just add on where your manhole is over, and then that gives you an overall length of how many meterage of pipe you need.